going to build this awesome animation of this floor animation, and believe me, this is only based on CSS. We're not gonna use JavaScript in this, and using only CSS we're gonna code this. So without wasting any time, let's just get started. So it is already written some code, but for you guys I'm gonna, you know, clear that all, like this way. And I'm using SCSS over here. You can use the CSS also. I'll let you know that how to work in CSS also. Okay, so just start this like dev class and some container. Let's have some container, and within this container we gonna have dev class equals to floor. And believe me, this is it for the HTML. We have coded HTML. I know you are not believing that we have completed the HTML right from the minutes. Okay, so start with the body now, like body and some, you know, men height. I, you know, used to give this men height GST 100 viewport height, and some background color, like as you already see over there, like this. And now my photograph is not, yeah, there's some dark. Okay, so like this way, that is perfect. And I'm going to, you know, align every item, like display flex center. So there are two properties, align item center to make the vertical alignment. So I'm gonna do this. And for the horizontal alignment, justify content center. So everything will be in center. Okay, so I'll give a general font size like 75 pixel. So that I used to have as a unit of any, you know, emphasize and all. And for that, now I gonna code for floor. Yeah, exactly. So some height, let's suppose 5 emphasize, and some width, let's suppose 5 emphasize, and some border just to make sure that we have created something or not, like the white border on the black, so we can see the element. Yeah, it is in center just because of display flex line item. Okay, so like this way we have created a lot of thing. And now there are some magic things, like I'm going to give the background image. Okay, so what we are going to do, like repeating conic and gradient, and how will it work, let's see. We'll start from 45 degree like this way. Okay, and then we'll have a color like black color, let's suppose some dark gray from 0 to 90 degree. I guess it will reflect it. Yeah, it is there. And some light dark to 90 degree to 180 degree. Will that be working? Yeah, it is working now. So as per the expectation, start from the 45 degree angle, and there is some conic gradient. Perfect. And now just to have the background size, we can have like background size 1 emphasize, like, and both the sizes 1 emphasize. So there are two things, 1 and 2, and I'm giving all this. So just to, you know, fading from the borders, I have one more, you know, I'm going to give some, you know, dissolve gradient over here, like at the corners, at the edges. I can have like a black color, so it can dissolve to the background. Okay, so I can remove this for now, like this. I don't need a border for here, and like this way. Okay, so I'm gonna have a radial gradient, okay, and comma for that. And what I'm going to have is like the RGB, like black with zero opacity and black color. So this is, and it is not, yeah, it is reflecting for every element. And now I need to give it for the size also, like for the 100% radius. And so this way it will should, yeah, so this way it is having like this. Okay, perfect. So far so good. So what we need to do, like we need to just, you know, rotate this like this way, 90 degree to the, you know, x-axis. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna transform it and rotate x, like on the x-axis I gonna rotate it. So let me rotate it till 60 degree once, so that we make sure that it is rotating. Let's wait for the execution. If it is working, transform, rotate it, and it is perfect. And now we need to, you know, change the perspective. So because it's getting, you know, like this way, so we can change the perspective or body perspective, like the distance. So perspective, then emphasize. So once I've done this, you can see like this. And now just grow this like 15 and 15, and we'll have a huge floor now. And let's just so here it is, the floor. So instead of 60, we can move it to 90. And once we have moved it to 90 degree, we won't be able to see this because it's just a thin line at the center, vertically center of the, you know, the, yeah, it's not visible. So for that, I gonna move like perspective origin. So I gonna see this horizontally center, and to the vertically instead of the center, in the middle, I'm just going to upward one emphasize, like, okay. So I gonna calculate 50% will be the center, and I'm going to minus it one emphasize. Okay, and what is emphasize? Is just this pixel, the phone size pixel, 75% pixel. Okay, so one emphasize is equivalent to 75 pixels. So I'm just looking from the top, and once I'm looking like this, you can see the floor just in, you know, in the down. Okay, so I just wait for that, and it will be looking like this. Okay, and now the last thing. So I need to capture this entire floor like a camera which can rotate through like 360 degrees. So I cannot move the camera. What I can do, I can move the entire floor. I can, you know, rotate the entire floor or the container of that floor. Okay, so for that container, what can I do? I can make a, you know, animation. You can say like at the rate key frames. Okay, and for that I can say like camera, which is like moving, like this way, and in that only having two where it ultimately goes. Okay, so in the two, what I'm going to write is like the transform rotate. Okay, rotate, I need to correct the spelling, rotate y 360 degree. Okay, and that is it. And for the container, because it's perspective from the body is that, so I need to like transform style. I need to have the transform style preserve 3D. Okay, so it should preserve the 3D look. Okay, and now I can use the animation, like what is the animation, which is like camera, and what is the time duration, let's say 30 seconds, and what will be the function of animation, that should be linear, and it should run infinite, and that is it, I guess. Finally we got the execution, so nothing bad in this, just code when taking time to load it, and that is it. So we have achieved this, like 3 lines of code in HTML, and like less than 40 lines of code in CSS. So ultimately we have achieved a wonderful animation within very less code, and I hope you like it if you have watched till the end. So like it, try it, and tell me what are the issues you are facing. And wait for the next awesome videos. There are a couple of more things, like I've created the cube, I've created the React logo through CSS and, you know, animating it, and some loading indicators. So everything I've covered in this description of this video. So please go and share this video for the friends. Thank you. Thank you so much.